So we are going biking.
Yes.
And eating ice cream.
Maybe.
Maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yes. Today we have a free day and we decided to stay active. So we are going biking to Zalew Nowohucki and wish us good luck.
So actually very funny, you said, wish us good luck. Normally in English, we don't say, wish me good luck. We just say, wish me luck. So obviously one of the perks, advantages of my work, being an English teacher, a private English coach, is I choose when I work. I decide my hours. I'm my own boss. So I don't clock in 9 to 5. If I want to take a day off, I do it. If I want to go bike riding on what day is it?
Tuesday,
I can do it.
Okay, and always remember, wear a helmet.
Yes, safety first. Welcome to Bike Cam. Ooh, I love this. This is going to be a great vlog. Once we get to where we're going, and I love to use the word get as a dotrzeć. Get is such an easy way to say dotrzeć instead of like arrive. Okay, so once we get to where we're going, which is Zalew Nowohucki, then I guess I want to talk about how I became an English teacher in Poland. Talk about that story, and Ania is going to help me talk about that because she's an important part of that story. I guess you're going to see me next when we get to the Zalew.
But if they say like wstęp zbroniony, then just don't go.
But it's open.
Just don't go, Danny.
I'll wait for a person to come and tell me get off the court.
As you can see, Danny is a rebel person.
What did you say?
Rebellious.
A rebel.
He's rebel, you know. And he's playing basketball right now.
Let's try it. Thank you. Let's try it. Oh yeah, they still got it. This might actually be the best ice cream place in Kraków.
Sure.
It's so good. Try it. You're gonna go crazy. Right there. Really good stuff, guys. Right there. Let's talk about how I became what I am now, an English teacher, but I don't like that title, English coach, English teacher in Poland. And I'll pass it off to you to start the story, because she was very important in this whole process, weren't you, Anya?
Maybe. Just a little bit, you know, for a start. So I remember when we first met, we started actually like speaking in Polish when we first met, so I didn't even realize that he was like foreign guy, kind of. And then after like a few moments of realization, I realized that he's actually from England. He was born in USA. He raised in UK. He was raised in UK. And I remember when we started like talking to each other, I asked like, what are you doing right now? I mean, like, what do you do on a daily basis? Do you work or study? And back then he started like studying and he didn't work or anything like this. So I told him immediately, I mean, you would be a great English teacher. Let me tell you why.
And I said, what? Really? Are you sure?
That's true. So let me tell you why. Like, first of all, he's a native speaker.
Native? What is this native?
Native speaker.
Native.
And secondly, he can also speak Polish, which is amazing. And you know, like I told him, he was very like shocked, like, wow, how can I be an English teacher while I barely speak in Polish?
I said my Polish isn't perfect, so I can't teach
and I
English
told him,
here.
And I told you, like, it doesn't matter if you speak fluently in Polish, it only matters that your English is perfect. And I remember what happened then.
I mean, at that time I was like I didn't see the potential that she saw. That's because I don't think I understood the market properly at that point in time, the English education market in Poland in general. I didn't understand how valuable native speakers were. Like, in general, I barely even heard the term native speaker in England. Because English people in English speaking countries, they don't really give a shit about learning other languages, because we already know English, the most important language in our mind. So we don't, I barely heard native speaker. And then Poland was like, native speaker. I was like, okay, this is really quite important for these guys, right?
It's a big deal. So then I said, oh, you should be a teacher. And he asked, like, how can I be a teacher? I said, like, you should put an offer. But he was kind of afraid, I would say. He didn't believe in himself. And so I did it. I put an offer as an English teacher. I did on all the leagues, Equa Petitia and other things like this.
I was so nervous, like, what if someone calls me? What do I say? Like,
yeah.
I was even writing a script of what I'm gonna say when I answer the phone.
That's true.
And back then, we say back then as if it was a long time ago. It wasn't that long ago, a couple years ago. 50 zlotych was my price. So if you saw that offer, you were lucky, you know, because the price has changed now. The price is a bit higher, let's say.
Yeah, so we put an offer and...
We put up an offer.
Put up an offer?
Yeah.
Okay. Sun is coming.
Sun's coming out.
So I remember he was like so stressed. He was asking me like, what should I say?
And then, like, I was like, what am I gonna do during the lesson? Like, what am I gonna teach them? Like, what should I do? Like, I had no idea. All I knew was that I can speak English very well.
And that was enough.
That was actually enough, because I didn't understand the market. And Poland was like so much about, everyone was used to learning from the book, right? And like,
true,
only from this perspective of tenses, like czasy, let's just study the grammar textbook but don't actually speak. And then I realized over time, people just want to speak, and it will be great if someone can correct them, someone who actually has good knowledge and native level knowledge of the language, someone who's people friendly like me, someone who can switch to Polish and maybe actually explain to them why they're making the mistakes that they're making. So actually, yeah, I had a lot of skills that I didn't realize were valuable when I started, but just over time I like realized what was important, what these people needed, how I could help them. And very quickly I started gaining confidence and saying, yeah, I can do this, and getting better. But I think at that time it was more of a hobby, like a side thing. I was teaching only a few people. Then I stopped. I think I got a corporate job, an internship at some company, QVC it was called. Shout out to QVC. Hated it. Hated the job.
Don't say the job.
I hated the job. And after that 6-month internship, I was doing nothing again, I think. But after a while...
No, I remember I wanted him to, like... I want him to... I want to push him into, like, teaching. I was so focused on that teaching. He started, yeah, and then he, like, stopped. And I was like, no, that's... That can be, you know? You're too good for that. You can't stop. And I was, like, pushing him. And I told him, maybe you should be, like, a native speaker at some school, English school. So I told him, like, oh, you should apply.
And I applied for some schools. Yeah. I even had a few interviews.
And he you had to, like, do, like, some course, and you did it,
yes.
But, you know, it was overdue.
You did some qualification. Things didn't work out with those schools, so I was, like, dead end again, nothing. And that's when I posted my first TikTok about English, where I was, like, testing people's pronunciation at my university, at UEK. Like, Polish students pronounce English words. My first TikTok was viral, 500,000 views. It went crazy. And from that moment on, I was making English content, like, all the time. And people were loving it, and it was very valuable. And people were like, wow, this kid's cool. He grew up in the UK. He's got a nice, cool British accent, but he's one of us. He's Polish. And from that point on, people were messaging me on Instagram and TikTok saying, hey, can I have a lesson with you? I said yes. So I was scheduling and arranging lessons and meetings, one-on-one conversations, just getting, and yeah, from that moment it kind of blew up. And from that moment I've been teaching, like, consistently, and I've taught a lot of people now. Some people, you know, I had for a few months as a student, some people for longer. But with each person, I get better and better. Let me say this. When I started, I had only a native understanding of the language. What do I mean by that? If you ask any native of any language, usually, explain the rules of grammar to me, please, of your language. They'll struggle to do it. Like,
it's true.
Can you explain the rules of grammar in Polish?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes, but, you know, like, I was kind of, like, ambitious student who I was studying everything.
All right, you're a bad example.
But, yeah, probably...
Most people don't understand, yeah, like, how their grammar works, but they can speak perfectly. And that's kind of the level I was at, I guess, kind of. So, I knew the language perfectly, and... Throughout teaching, with each lesson, I was actually just on the fly learning why we use the language the way we do, and the names of all the tenses, and I think it's easier that way if you understand the language first and then you study the science of the grammar, not start by just learning grammar only, and that's what kids do at school. So that was an interesting part of the journey, and I'm still, like, learning new things here and there, which is cool, because you never want to stop learning. Even a teacher has to be a student. Here we are now. Yeah,
so maybe to summarize the whole conversation, what I saw in Daniel was definitely, like, a person with a lot of English knowledge. So, like I said, it's very unusual to meet person who actually was born in the USA, raised in UK, and then come back to Poland to their roots, you know. So basically it's very unusual to meet person like this. And then even if you have that person who is native and who can also speak Polish fluently, it's very hard to find a person who is so passionate about that language and fully understand that language. So Daniel is that kind of person, you know. He you can imagine, you know, we moved in right now, and he had, like, hundreds of books about, like, English language.
Books, you know. I live my life in English, you know, like, my life is English. I was raised English speaking country, and that's my lifestyle. Like, I still read books in English. I listen to English music. I don't listen to Polish music. I watch all my content in English. Interviews, podcasts, YouTube videos, YouTubers, it's all in English. I live an English life, except for the fact that I'm in Poland, right? And I speak Polish sometimes when I'm out and about, but
yeah. And the last thing, you know, even if you're a native, even if you can speak Polish, even if you're passionate about language, you have to have like that thing of teaching, you know. It's not everyone was born to be a teacher, like for example, I'm a maths teacher. I do maths, I'm a mathematician, but I know a lot of people who can do maths, who can like actually like amazing in maths. They fully understand it, a lot of things,
but they can't teach,
you know.
You copied my British accent.
Sorry. so yeah, that's like, to be a teacher, it's a very difficult
when I came to Poland and I saw that my university classmates, who were just Polish people who had like a decent level of English, decent, it's okay, when I found out that they were teaching English, I was like, what's going on here? Your English is decent, but a teacher?
Yeah.
So when I saw that, I was like, okay, I can do this. This country needs good teachers, and I need to step up and be one. So that's what I'm doing now. I'm trying to be a good teacher, trying to spread the passion of English, the love of English, and that's the mission right now.
And like I said, why Danny is also unique.
Stop boasting about me.
No, you're very special, and I knew it since I met you, that, you know, like there are like a lot of Polish English teachers, let's say. I mean, probably everyone who knows a little bit of English can be an English teacher, and we know how it works. In Poland,
especially with social media now, anyone can claim to be a teacher. I've seen people make content without even speaking. They just fair true. Enough, you know. It's a free market, so you can try, but you'll be competing with me.
So people actually don't really look for like Polish people who can speak English. People more likely like want to like native speakers. But also they're afraid of them because they can't speak Polish, so they're afraid of not understanding and having a part of like struggling with communication. So here we are. We have Daniel, amazing example of this. So we should I'm gonna take care of him, but you should also take care of him.
Take care of me.
Follow him,
by
support him.
Dropping that like. Subscribing to my channel so we can get this message out to more people, hundreds of people, thousands of people, maybe hundreds of thousands of people who are also passionate about learning the English language, because that's what we're spreading, that's what we're here to do. The more you follow me, the more I'll do for you.
That's true.
So
he needs that boost.
I need that boost, you know. I'm trying to go all in with this content.
He does that for free, so you should be grateful.
Yes,
to follow him.
Yes.
He's amazing.
All right.
I can promise.
Sun's out. Have a good day. Thanks for watching.